I am cleaning up this 1963 Rider's Powertone shell, snare shell. Just wanted to document it a little bit here. Here we go, a little bit better lighting. The wrap on this is very tight. Okay. Focus is great on this camera. So, the edge is quite dirty. But I'm not sure how to clean that. I don't want to sand it, so I'm just going to leave it the way it is. Next owner can do what they will with that. There we go. Hang on. Maybe this will help. Anyways, some of you may be wondering about that. I don't see any evidence of any cracking going on. Those are like the indentations, you know, from the brads being pushed over. They didn't do it with these new ones. So here's another view. How's that for a view, folks? All right. On the looking at the wrap. See how dirty it used to be here? Look how dirty that is. All right. You know, hang on, I think I gotta, let's turn this on. There we go. Got a light on this camera. Might help the situation. It's pretty dirty. Marked up quite a bit. So, quite dirty, and then I started cleaning right here at the eyelet, which turned out to be pretty clean too. They're scratching around these parts. It's like they were trying to trace these lugs and stuff like that. I really don't understand the logic behind that. Maybe they were tracing to make a template for some gaskets or something. It's the only thing I can think of. Sort of strange. Here's a really good example of it. Just to show that it's not just an example of the piece being mounted tight like that. Here's the next one, which I believe is for a muffler, I think. Here, see that? Okay. Hopefully you can see that. It's got a little bit of fade, but not too bad. Just looks a little milkier. Quite a bit of shine, but here, let me show this real fast. Get a look at the wrap. Alright. Clean, dirty. Dirty. There, see? I got these marks. Who knows what's gonna happen to these? I'll tell you in a moment. I'll tell you in the video. She's pretty dirty up here. Alright, maybe I'm going overboard trying to document this. Oh, I'm finally back to my air vent, so I'll be done pretty soon. I just wanted to try to document as much as possible. It's a little fun, you know. It is what it is. It's hard to say how many plies this is. You get the best view here. See, it looks like there could be a darker ply on the outside, but then again, that might just be the dirt. From the dirty edge. Let me try this. Just turn the light off. There we go. Come on, focus in. I was picking up the background. The gray painted interior reinforcement ring there pops right up to it. Try one more thing. Sorry for taking so long, folks. Trying to give you a good view. Going outside, lighting could be pretty good, but it's a gray day, so there's not a whole lot of sunshine, but it's a lot of light, I'm hoping. Let's take a look. Hi. How about that? tough. So it looks like it could be 3-ply with reinforcement rings. Then if you look inside the hole, one of these holes, yeah, it makes sense. Yeah. 3-ply with 3 rings. Let me try to find a really good hole to look in. I can find holes, but to look in, not really gonna help too much. It doesn't really help. Alright. At any rate, there's another look on the inside of the shell. Just a plastic lens cap hitting the shell. Nothing to be concerned about. All right. Couple joints there. And let me check the other side. And right there. Joints are moved over just a little bit. And boy, hey, you guys, it's stamped with an F right there. I don't know what that means. If someone does, please let me know. I may have already figured out before I post this. There's the F again over here, I believe. F. F. Okay. Maybe that's the name of the guy who put him in there. I don't know. It's not Fullerton, because this is a Cleveland drum. Was there a Fullerton factory? Maybe I'm getting my companies mixed up. I don't know. All right. There it is, folks. It is what it is. Okay. Be slapping it together soon. Talk to you later. Thanks. Bye. Okay, folks. Let me change hands here. Just got done cleaning this shell up. Okay, I got good news and bad news. Bad news is not very bad, though. Alright. Let me get it over here first. Alright. This is a 63 Rogers Powertone snare, and now you may have seen in my previous videos what this used to look like. I'm done cleaning it up now. Now, a couple things I need to make sure you understand. I meticulously cleaned this by hand with a microfiber cloth to make sure that I did not get any water in the holes or on the edges. So I specifically did not try to get too close to the edge. I'm going to let the next owner do that, as evident right there. See that, folks? Come on, focus.
There we are, see?
Alright. Just because I don't want to get the edge wet, you guys may end up, well, doing however you do it. I have not done much in terms of polishing up drum wrap at all on any of my drums, so I just wanted to get it really clean and let you guys polish it up. That's the bad, well, the bad news is that this is showing some wear, you know, some use, scratches, dings, whatever. Okay. But as you can see, the shine is quite beautiful. Let's see. I wonder if you can see any of this, any of these scratches. Yeah, see, a little bit. See that one right there? There we go, see? Ouch. There's a good one right there. Right there. I'm trying to give a really, really accurate description of this drum. I don't want anyone to open it up in a box. To discover that it's got more use, more age, more scratching than they wanted. It's sort of hard to see. In a moment, I'm going to go outside, see there's some scratching around the vent. See it there? There we go, that's good. Already showing you that. Okay, that's the extent of it, pretty much. Ouch, careful of the brads. Alright, so, you'll see that I have not... Okay. Let me tell you what I did. You already probably know. I used some Dawn and some of this stuff right here and in there. Alright. And I used a microfiber towel right there. And then when I was done, I used some glass cleaner, aka Windex, whatever you want to call it, with another microfiber towel and cleaned it up. So that's what you get. It is really shiny. The good news is that when, you know, this has not, it already looks this good, and it has not yet seen any kind of polishing product, Novus 1 or 2 or 3, or any headlight cleaner, you know, any of the little products we use to shine up the wrap, and it already looks this good. So when you finally get this and take it apart and wrap and clean up the wrap, it's going to look just fabulous. Okay? Alright. I think that is another view on the... It's not very discolored at all. I mean, it's just... It's sort of hard to see it. Of course, this wrap makes it challenging. Come on, though. Boy, it looks darn good, you guys. The inside, another shot of the inside. You know, I think that's enough. I mean, you can make these videos too darn long. It's gonna drive you guys crazy. don't know, it sort of looks funky right there. I guess that's just glue from the manufacturing, because everything's painted. And I think it's all factory. Okay. I've already shown a lot of this on previous recordings. Another shot of this. Okay. All right. Gotta go slab together now. Okay? We'll see you again later. Thanks. Bye. Mark Bullen, in case you're wondering, from T-Rex. Well, good morning, folks. I've been up all night working on this. Slapping this snare together. This is a 1963 Rogers Powertone. 8 lugs with a steel gray ripple pearl wrap. Steel gray ripple pearl wrap. I thought before, I slap all this together, I can get and show you folks what we're looking at here. In terms of, so we'll try this, the inside, you know what I mean? And it's turned out to look pretty good. That's pretty heavy to carry with one hand. Whoa, dropped it. Whoa, just kidding. I'm a kidder. I don't have the wires slapped on there yet, but, alright. I think I lost some screws, so I had to substitute. Alright. Here and there. I like that one right there. Alright. Sorry. Roller coaster ride. Oh, we're so dizzy. Okay, sorry about that. Mainly the the screws for the butt end. Okay. That's what I had to replace. Luckily, I had some. I didn't write that, by the way. It says, other side of snare or something like that. Previous owner wrote that, apparently. But I'm leaving it, you know, because I'm going to leave everything the way I found it, you know. I got this all put together. I'll try to clean it up a little bit, but you know, it gets chalky. I know I'm boring the crap out of you here. Let me give you a view of the throw off. I took it all apart, cleaned it all up, soaked all the little parts, you know. Then I there we go. There we are. I lubed up the parts with Vaseline petroleum jelly. There is some pitting throughout this drum, folks. Can you see it there? Yeah. It's definitely a player's drum. A player, not a collector. But, anyways, there, I pretty much have the inside how I wanted, what I wanted to do. Turned out looking good. Alright. So, okay, I'm gonna finish it up, try to get a little bit of snooze. Rims turned out looking really nice. Polished the rims and all the hardware up. I got some, by the way, nylon washers, folks. And though I will be including the steel ones for those old school players. But I thought I'd give you the option and let you try these out. These are really smooth. Okay? Anyways, some of you will appreciate that. Some of you probably will not care at all. Anyways, oh, and the wrap, I know I'm a little repetitive here. It's shining up really nice. I mean, look at that, you know. That's pretty beautiful. But it could be better. I did not novice these. I didn't shine them up at all. I just cleaned them very meticulously with a microfiber, or yeah, microfiber towel. Very careful not to scratch it up any more than it is. So there it is so far. See you in a while. Thanks. Bye. Okay, hello, folks. I think we're recording. Hope so. Alright, it is done. All cleaned up. 1963 Rogers Powertone snare, 8 lugs, got rear rings. This is wrapped in a very beautiful steel gray ripple pearl. Steel gray ripple pearl is the color. Let me get you going here. See it? There we are. It's a beauty, eh? Alright, I'm gonna show you guys. By the way, brand new head. Brand new Remo coated ambassador. The bottom is the one that came on it when I got it. Remo ambassador snare. By the way, the wires are Ludwig wires. They look to be pretty old. I don't have any other wires to put on these right now, on this, so I thought I would just leave these on here. It's missing a few strands. It has a total of 15 wires, you guys. Okay? By the way, this is the number on this is 2145. The Rogers number, serial, I guess you would call it, is 2145. It is a Cleveland drum. It's been dated to be a 1963. There are absolutely no cracks in this wrap. None whatsoever. It's got quite a beautiful shine there. There is some, well, let me show you a few more things. I think I need to wash my hands. I'm leaving prints on here. There is some pitting on this drum. It definitely shows its age, that it was played, and not this isn't a collector's drum. It's had its share of gigs, let me put it that way. So there's some pitting on here. I'm gonna try to get some close-up examples. You find a good one, I guess. Let's see, see it right on the butt end. Okay. Alright, sorry if this is boring you guys, there's a really good focus on this camera. And I wanted to take advantage of that. There is some scratches on the wrap. There's nothing that really stands out. You know, no big gouges or anything like that. There's this right here. I want to make sure to show that to you. If I could even get to see it, it's right. I can barely see it. It's right there. There's that right there. It will be rubbed out. And it's really hard to show you. Here, let me show you this lug. See? One of the problems is that, this might sound funny for me to say, but they're so clean and shiny that there's a lot of reflection going on, therefore it's harder to see. The pitting. Here we go, see? But, you know, from this far, it's a gorgeous drum. Man, this video doesn't turn out nearly as good as I wanted it to be. I'm sorry. Let me just give you a good look-see around. Let me show you see. There we go. See what I'm talking about, you guys? It's got a great focus. I cleaned out this, I took this apart, all apart, and I cleaned it all up big time. There's no rust at all on this thing anymore, obviously. The hoops are in really, really good condition. Minor pitting. Very minor. The worst thing with the hoops is, if you can see on the inside, I don't know if you'll be able to pick this up or not. Now I'm going to try something. Hang on. No, I'm not sure that helps. there's a line of scratch going all the way around the inside of the tube. It's worse in some spots than others. And I believe it's from someone throwing a cymbal on top of it while they were transporting them. It's not too bad, though. I mean, you don't ever see that unless you're playing it. You look real close. Alright, folks. You may have noticed that I have not tuned this up. I'll leave that to you guys. I don't have the time. Honestly, I've got about 40 eels going right now that I gotta attend to. I threw on some nylon washers. Some of you may like that. Some of you really don't care. I don't know. I'm also going to throw in the steel washers upon your request if you want to. Anyways, I anticipate throwing those in. Okay. It is what it is. It's beautiful. Oh, the wrap. I cleaned it all up, and it's got a good shine kicking right here, as you can see. But the thing is about it, it's going to be able to shine up and clean up a lot better once you use, you know, like some of the Novus products or any of the many other products that you have, you know, that clean them up, polish them up. I've never polished and shined up wrap. I haven't crossed that bridge yet. I bought some stuff, I just haven't got around to getting it out and doing it because I've been so busy with so many things going on right now, including stuff like this. This cleaned up real well. This air vent, very nice. As you can see, it's a beauty. Alright, I'm going to sign off now. Okay, folks? Thanks.